Before going into space, here's why NASA stopped exploring oceans. What happened to NASA's ocean pictures? Anyone who uses the internet has been asking that question for a while now. Did NASA really look into the oceans? Is the question everyone wants to know right now? So let's watch this video and find out. It's hard for most people to see how NASA is related to underwater exploration. A lot of people think that NASA only works on finding new things in space and not in the ocean. However, recent discoveries and ideas show a different perspective. NASA might want to look into the ocean to learn more about the ocean and space. The NASA mission to space takes us into unknown areas of our planet. The beautiful oceans are part of that. You might ask why they started to look around. What did they end up finding? What happened to NASA's trips on the water? All the information you need is in this video. Why did NASA want to learn about the sea? NASA has done several ocean research projects that have used the oceans on Mars and the Moon. The water is so deep, the pressure is so high, and there isn't much sunlight, so more than 80% of the world's seas are completely unknown. This is because of the combination of these factors. With the Aquarius project and the Astronomical Science and Technology project, ESSP, these questions will be answered. A spacecraft called Grace was launched on March 17, 2002, to study changes in the ocean's mass field that had not been seen before. This is important for learning about both climate change and how oceans circulation. In space, the Aquarius project, which launched on June 10, 2011, was supposed to study the saltiness of the oceans. Groups of pilots, engineers, and scientists are sent to live on Aquarius. They are called NEMO. Aquarius is where scientists work for up to 3 weeks at a time. There is no other study station in the world like this one. Aquarius scientists were interested in how the ocean is changing and how the coral reefs are doing. Because of pollution, disease, overfishing, and climate change, coral reefs are in danger in their own area, in the region, and around the world. As a result of NASA's explorations of the ocean, information and technology have been developed that are now utilized in a wide variety of fields of study and practice. Specifically, ocean vector winds, which are determined by scatterometers and precision altimeters, are responsible for determining the topography of the ocean's surface. Why did NASA find something in the ocean that caused them to be so concerned? People were wondering, why did NASA stop exploring the ocean? Because of a popular TikTok video. It was in March of 2021 when the TikTok account known as Memes to Click uploaded a video in which it was stated that NASA's original mission was to search the oceans. When it is stated in the video that they, NASA, won't tell us what they found, but their plans have suddenly changed to getting us off this planet ASAP, the video quickly transforms into a conspiracy theory. This video is just one of many that shows the work that NASA is doing to explore the ocean. TikTok user TimeTraveler73 posted the following message: "You aren't alone on Earth. It is right in front of you where the danger is." That's something NASA knows. Another TikTok video uploaded by JDippy11 claims that the National Aeronautics and NASA investigated reports of missing boats from the 1980s, discovered a massive unknown species, and then stopped conducting research on the oceans. This is the question that is asked in the video available on TikTok. It's not relevant, though. Exploring the ocean wasn't one of NASA's main goals at first. In other words, let us be honest. The first objectives of NASA were more people understanding of things that happen in space. Improvements in terms of efficiency of both air and space vehicles have been made. Vehicles that are capable of transporting both people and goods into space, creating long-term studies to explore the science and peaceful uses of space and aviation, protecting the United States of America's position as the world leader in the fields of aviation and space science. NASA's mission was not to investigate the oceans. Rather, it was to investigate space and the atmosphere. If NASA has never conducted any research into the oceans, then why are so many people having the opposite opinion? It's all about getting people's attention, just like everything else that has to do with the internet. If you want to increase the number of people who follow you on social media platforms such as TikTok, YouTube, and other platforms, you can easily do so by telling a terrifying story about how NASA abruptly stopped all ocean research. People will keep coming as long as they click on and watch these videos. Does NASA look into the ocean in any way? Do you know what the ocean looks like, NASA? Maybe not the way you think, but yes. Goddard Space Flight Center, GESFC, was created by NASA in 1959, producing satellite equipment for the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration, NOAA, is one of the company's primary responsibilities. The company was established in 1970. NOAA is responsible for monitoring and researching the weather and climate systems. It analyzes data to determine how weather systems change and to make predictions about how they will change in the future. It then communicates its findings to the general public and to partner organizations. At NOAA, the Office of Ocean Research, OA, pays for research projects and trips. Therefore, NASA's trips are not their job, even if they give it money and or organizational power. NASA also studies the oceans through trips with ESSP Earth System Science Pathfinder, the GRACE, Gravity Recovery and Climate Experiment Program, which NASA and the German Aerospace Center, DLR, started in 2018, represents one of the programs trying to find changes in gravity. When there is a change in the amount of clean water in different parts of the world, gravity anomalies are possible. Although these views involve water and the seas, they are not themselves ocean trips. Also, NASA's Aquarius mission, which began in 2008, makes maps and counts of how salty the world's seas are and how salt moves around the planet. However, both of these projects attempt to observe the ocean from a space-based perspective. They get most of their news from satellites. The question is, what part of the ocean has not been discovered yet? NOAA says that more than 80% of the world's oceans have not been mapped, seen, or visited. That's because some oceans around the world are not accessible. Because the temperature drops below a certain threshold, it becomes difficult to see anything, and the enormous pressure causes anything that shouldn't be here to break. Since the beginning of time, people have been interested in the oceans. Since the beginning of time, we have been exploring the cosmos in search of new places to visit and new experiences to have. Since the beginning of time, the oceans have played a significant role in the development of life, transportation, commerce, innovation, and inspiration. The seas are the biggest ecosystem on Earth because they cover more than 71% of the surface and hold 99.9% of all habitable space. We have even found some of their strange underwater structures, like the Mariana Trench and the Bermuda Triangle. The Mariana Trench is 7 miles deep and the deepest place on Earth. Remember that towns have been found underwater. Palvopetri, which is located in Greece, is approximately 5,000 years old and may have been buried in water around the year 1000 BC. We are still not sure how big the seas are or what lives in them, no matter how hard we try. We might already know more about space than about the oceans. We have better maps of the surface of Mars and the Moon compared to the bottom of the ocean, said Dr. Gene Feldman, an oceanographer at NASA. We have a lot more information about the surface of Mars. Now for the most important question of the day, why did NASA stop looking into the oceans? Scientists at NASA have been trying to find out what's below the waves for at least 10 years now. Many people think that NASA has stopped exploring the ocean, but that's not true. A technical issue put an end to the Aquarius mission in 2015. In the same year, the Gravity Recovery and Climate Experiment came to an end as well. This was due to the GRACE 2 satellite being taken out of service due to its old age. However, in 2021, NASA collaborated with deep sea dive excursions in order to develop technology for the Europa expedition. Since this happened, people won't be as eager to explore the ocean for a while. NASA will make incredible progress forward in the next few years thanks to the great things that are happening now. In the end, and this is the end of the video for today, feel free to tell us what you think about this. Do you believe NASA has ever explored the ocean, and did they ever stop? We have a lot of information, but no one knows what NASA hides under the oceans. What creature or monster is under there? And why is that? Is it because it really is dangerous to go there? As the water is so deep, the pressure high, and not much sunlight. No one knows! Tell us what you think in the comments. Remember to like and subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching.